So what prompted me to do this video today was because of the lack of information or lack of enough information on what the senator is supposed to do for their people. Even those who were vying for the senatorial position didn't know what was required of them according to the constitution. For instance, a whole senatorial candidate are giving outrageous promises to the people that they are going to make to build hospitals or construct roads, which is not in their role in the constitution of Kenya. Thus, the people will have too much expectation of them, such that after 5 years, they will be asked, where are the roads that you promised us? Where are the hospitals that you promised us? So we will jump straight to the introduction. And the Senate is under the legislative arm of government and acts independently of the other arms of government. Following the new constitution of 2010, the first election that included the election of senators was done in the year 2013. The new constitution aimed at the separation of powers specifically to each individual county. The Senate determined the case of this resolution, amendments, nominations, and impeachment motions by unanimous voting. So the Senate constitutes the first batch of the 57 elected members. They are elected by registered voters of the 47 counties of the country of Kenya. So these 47 members need to meet the criteria provided by the institution, and they are elected by the registered voters of the various counties they represent. For instance, a senator vying in Uasin Gishu, he first meets all the requirements needed for him to become a senator, and then he or she is accepted by the IEBC's officials, he can then go campaign in Uasin Gishu County, and the registered voters will then decide. So the 47 are elected, and the party that has the majority will then nominate 16 women members, 2 members representing the people with disabilities, 1 a man and 1 a woman, 2 members representing the youth, 1 a man and 1 woman. And lastly, the 47 elected members will then decide or vote for a speaker. The speaker should be an ex-official member, so he is elected by the Senate member. So it goes without saying that the members of the party that has the majority senators will decide there for their own speaker. So the roles of the senator, there are 3 roles: representation, legislation, and oversight. So you notice that in these roles there is nothing mentioned of him being given the mandate to build roads or construct hospital or schools, such and such. So their main role is legislation, representation, and oversight. So we'll first look at representation as one role of the senator. This is the most crucial responsibility of a senator. They are tasked with collecting information and opinions of the counties they represent. These opinions then act as a foundation for which to pass bills and laws that suit the interests of the counties they represent. So one thing the senators are faced to do in the first year is that they are failed to go down to the people who elected them and ask for their opinions on various issues that affect the counties they represent. For instance, they can give opinion on the revenue amount they want to be allocated to the county. So the main problem that they fail is in collecting information and opinions. So the second role of a senator is legislation. Opinion will still form a basis in this role in identification and passing of new laws that protect the citizens. Thus, a senator is required to be both active and vocal in order to earn support for the bill in favor of the country. So, the main criteria in selecting a senator of whom to vote for is that he or she should be active and vocal. You should consider a senator who will confidently air the opinions of the country they have been elected in. So they will select the laws that will protect the citizens. So they should have the citizens in their act as the most important party in the selection of new laws. The last role of a senator is oversight. So before oversighting, they should determine first the revenue allocation for the counties and then oversee the expenditure. So they are given the mandate to ask the governors of the counties they represent on how they have been able to use the money allocated to them. And under this role, they can impeach the sitting president, the deputy president, the governor, and the deputy governor as prescribed by the Constitution of Kenya. So they have the power to remove a sitting president, a deputy president, a governor, and a deputy governor. So there are many requirements by law on how to undergo this. They just don't sit down and remove a sitting president. There are various rules to follow. There are various rules to follow. They can also reject nominations presented by a sitting president. So, points to note, the Senate is together with the National Assembly under the legislative arm of government can make the functioning of a sitting president difficult if the majority members are of the opposing party to the ruling party. In the instance this happens, the sitting president will have to accommodate the opposing party for smooth running of government operations. This was seen in 2008-2007 when Honorable Mwai Kibaki won but did not have the majority numbers in both the Senate and the National Assembly. So he had to accommodate Honorable Raila Odinga by imposing the handshake in a way. So they both shared the government equally 50-50 because if Mwai Kibaki had not included Raila Odinga, he would not have run the government smoothly. So it's very important for a sitting president to have a majority number of senators in the Senate and the members of the National Assembly. So in the 2022 election, you may have noticed that there were 4 presidential candidates and only 2 had the most number in the Senate and the National Assembly candidates who were vying. But when you look at George Odekoa and Maure, they did not even have a single member running for a position in the government. So if, for instance, George Odekoa had been, for example, had been elected as a presidential candidate, his government would be null and void. For instance, he would not have been able to conduct nominations or pass bills in the parliament because they would be shut down by the opposing party. So it's very important for a sitting president to have the majority numbers in both the Senate and the National Assembly. So the Senate and the National Assembly go hand in hand. So that is the end of my video, and you may make a comment below on what I have focused on and what I failed to do. Thank you.